Hello, my name is Taetsu Kim. I'm the director of Voces Celestium, meaning Heavenly Voices. We are a not-for-profit charity organization dedicating ourselves to bringing changes to the world through music. Voces Celestium has been doing annual concerts to raise funds for multiple causes and have raised close to 100,000 Australian dollars, entirely donated to local and international charities, chosen in each of those performing years. Charities include Fred Hollows Foundation, Compassion Australia, Oxfam Australia, International Justice Mission, Doctors Without Borders, World Wildlife Fund, Beyond Blue, UNICEF, etc. And we will continue to walk on this charitable journey. The very start of the organization was a little invited performance from Open High School in Randwick, where I learned my Japanese as part of my high school certificate exam in 2012. I involved two of my high school friends to perform in their presentation day. And after that, we were invited to perform in a few other places before we decided to have our own charitable concert once a year from 2014. We mainly have two groups of performers in each of the concert, and that is orchestra and choir. Majority of the instrumentalists are scholars or graduate students from Sydney Conservatorium of Music, UNSW, and University of Sydney, but also some are from the members of Sydney Symphony Orchestra and Opera Australia. Some are even talented high school students from Conservatorium High School. So basically, we are a group of Australian musicians who got together to make a difference through what we normally do in our lives. Certainly, on Sunday 22nd of September in Sydney Town Hall at 7 p.m, we are marking our 10 years of dedication to using music as a vehicle for positive change. And this year we are raising funds for Save the Children and their work and efforts in Gaza, supporting children devastated by Israel's relentless bombardment of Gaza. We'll be performing Mahler Symphony No. 2, Resurrection, which I think it very well summarizes our 10 years of work. This concert is unique not only because it marks our 10th anniversary, but also because of its large scale, enormous scale in fact, and the collaboration that's involved. We have never presented our concert in this scale before, so we are very excited to bring this to our fans and fellow public. Yes, of course. Mahler's Second Symphony is a monumental piece that symbolizes renewal and hope. And to me, the piece was simply perfect to showcase our organization's growth and to summarize our 10 years of dedication. And not only that, Mahler 2, known as a Resurrection Symphony, embodies the theme of devastation, anguish, and suffering of death, which then leads into the themes of rebirth and hope and the triumph of human spirit. These themes resonate deeply with our mission to support children in Gaza who are enduring incomprehensible distress. And I truly believe that the depth of music and the impact of this particular symphony make it an ideal piece to convey our message of solidarity and humanitarianism. Of course, Gustav Mahler's Symphony No. 2, commonly known as, again, Resurrection Symphony, is arguably one of the most profound and powerful works in the symphonic repertoire. It was composed between 1888 and 1894, as far as I remember, sorry if I'm wrong, marking a significant evolution in Mahler's compositional style, reflecting his deep philosophical and existential concerns. Mahler began composing the symphony in 1888, shortly after completing his first symphony. And the first movement was initially conceived as a standalone symphonic poem titled Totenfeier, which translates as funeral rites. Over the next few years, Mahler has expanded this concept into a full symphony, incorporating a chorus and solos in the final movement, which was groundbreaking at the time. In fact, as far as I know, the only other symphony which had the chorus part in his time was the Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, which we performed last year. The symphony was premiered in 1895 in Berlin, and it eventually gained recognition as one of Mahler's most important works, renowned for its emotional depth and innovative structure. The Resurrection Symphony is a five-movement work. Most of the symphonies that we hear has four movements. This one has five. That explores themes of life, death, and the afterlife. The first movement, Allegro Maestoso, is a funeral march that sets a somber tone, a very dark and heavy tone. And the second and third movements provide contrast with lighter and more reflective music. And the fourth movement, Urlicht, which means primeval light, introduces a human voice with a poignant solo for a mezzo-soprano. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful piece, which conveys a sense of spiritual longing. And the final movement, In Tempo des Scherzos, is the heart of the symphony. It's the climax of the symphony. And it features a massive choral finale. And the words come from the poem titled Die Auferstehung. And Die Auferstehung translates as The Resurrection, where the title of the symphony comes from. And it was written by Friedrich Klopstock, and the lyric has some additional text by Mahler himself. And this movement culminates in a powerful declaration of faith in resurrection and eternal life, making it a profound statement on human existence and the triumph of the spirit. I think our main challenges are usually two things. One is recruiting and securing musicians in such a large scale, and that is always a big challenge. We are still recruiting our players, so if you are watching this, if you are watching this and wish to be part of the orchestra or choir for Mahler, let us know, reach out to us. We're more than happy to work with you. It'll be our honor, it'll be our joy. The other crucial part and biggest challenge in organizing these charity concerts are getting enough sponsorships and securing the right amount of finance. To put something in this scale as a not-for-profit charity organization, it simply requires support from companies and individuals, and it cannot be done without financial supports from different companies and grants. We were a bit unfortunate this year not being successful to receive any grants from the government. But again, I mean, we have been fortunate enough to receive generous support from countless musicians and professionals from different areas and from multiple communities. So if you're in a position where you can support us, financially, please reach out to us. There's no such thing as a meaningless donation. Every dollar, every single dollar counts for us to make these events successful. When it comes to challenges though, anything can happen unexpectedly preparing these events, and we should all be prepared to cover it and also prepared mentally, which is easier said than done. We're still learning, I am still learning, and there's still a lot to learn, but I am sure that decade of experience will come handy when we face any more challenges. Beyond attending the concert, Audience members can support our cause by spreading the word, obviously, about the event, making additional donations to save the children so that we can raise more funds, and participating in our fundraising concert. There are options for extra donations, by the way, in our ticketing website, so you can also check that out. And we're also receiving separate donations on the day of our concert at the venue as well. You can also engage with our social media, and you can invite your friends and family to join the concert. All of these can be an excellent way to support our concert. We hope attendees, including the musicians and all performers, leave with a profound sense of connection and inspiration. We want them to feel the power of music to unite and heal, and to understand the impact their support can have on saving lives in Gaza. Ultimately, we aim to foster a sense of strong community and shared purpose, reminding everyone that together we can make a significant difference. Yeah, just three things. I already mentioned it. We are still recruiting both orchestra members and choristers to perform with us. So if you are a musician, if you're a singer, if you're an instrumentalist, and you wish to perform with us and share this experience, please let us know. I think anyone should be excited to work on Mahler too. And I mean, I am very excited myself to restudy this music. I've studied this music in my masters and I'm revisiting it. You will really, really love it. So I promise that you won't regret participating. So please let us know. Secondly, we are still desperate with more sponsorships. I already mentioned this as well. Everything that we do, including hiring venues, hiring instruments, signing any contracts, insurances, music purchasing, to designing, to printing, to advertising, all of this needs funds. Regardless of our charitable work, these are unavoidable costs which we have to spend on. Now, we are so blessed to have hundreds of musicians generous enough to volunteer, using their valuable time and effort to practice their music, attend multiple rehearsals, attend the concert to make a difference in this world. We are doing our absolute best to make a difference in this world as a musician. So we would really appreciate if any of you can become our sponsor, because without you, we will simply not exist. And lastly, without audience, our work has no meaning. We have started selling our tickets online. Can have a look at our poster here, beautiful poster. There's a little QR code down here where you can just scan it, which would lead to our ticketing website. In fact, you know what? This is the QR code. I'm gonna arrange a separate QR code here, right there. So you can scan this right now. You can scan this QR code right now, and then you'll be able to see that leads to our ticketing website. So please secure your seats and share our story. Let people know that this is happening. Now, we donate 100% of our proceeds to the charity. We have never taken a single cent out of the ticket sales to compensate our expenditures in our previous events. All the money that goes into organizing this concert are covered by the sponsors. That's why sponsorship is so important to us. I mean, as a matter of fact, we usually round it up with extra donations from our company funds to send it to the charity. What we're trying to say is that we try our best to donate. Everything that comes from you goes to the charity. We do our absolute best. So do yourself a favor to watch a very, very nice concert in the Sunday evening, all prepared for you to enjoy while supporting an essential cause to support the Save the Children. Yes, I would love to express a few special thanks, and I would like to thank our sponsors, especially Gospel Pianos and Bendigo Bank. They have been our longest sponsors since the start of our organization. And this was when I was merely a university student. Without them, it would not have been even possible to start this journey. So I thank you very, very much. And there are more sponsors I would like to mention. And these are the sponsors who are also very supportive of us and have been sponsoring us multiple times within those 10 years of journey. One is Vision Asset Group, who is in fact one of our main supporters. And Tim Burrows Fitness, the best gym in Sydney ever. I have my personal trainer there. Please check them out, Tim Burrows Fitness. E-Planet Scrap Metals, they've been supporting us multiple times. Thank you very much. Good Seat Church as well. Thank you very much. And Sydney Korean United Church. Thank you very, very much. All the sponsors, thank you. And I'd like to extend my sincerest gratitude to those members who have participated in our concert for 10 years straight. Can you believe that? 10 years without missing single one of them. I'm gonna start by saying thank you so much. And to start off, Pavle Zajc, who is our co-director and co-founder of this organization. This is a personal message to you. I don't know what to say. It's been a long journey. It has been an honor to have a friend like you. So I thank you so much. Your existence really means a world to me. So thank you so much. And thank you so much for your work and support and being such an amazing friend and such an amazing, in a way, director. You know, we would not have existed without you. So thank you so much. And also, I'd like to mention our concert master, Yan Hee Kim. Thank you very much. And Zhijin Kao, our clarinetist. Thank you very much. Daniel Parkey and Tanya Ma, our two violinists. Thank you very much. And Diana Kim, who is our chorister, and she's in soprano. Thank you very much. All these people, which I've just mentioned, they have not missed a single concert, never missed a single year. Thank you most sincerely for trusting me and our organization. Your generous heart and dedication is what made us today. So thank you very, very much. I mean, I don't know how else I can express this. Thank you a million times. Okay, thank you very much. May God bless you all, and I'll see you in the concert. Bye-bye.